Hello everyone, and welcome to Sine of Our Time. My name is Bruce, and I hope you're ready for a more challenging example of polynomial long division. Now, this example is not for the faint-hearted. So if you're just starting to learn about polynomial long division, well, then I recommend you try an easier example by looking at the first video in this series in the link above. However, if this level of spiciness on the Shisa meter doesn't scare you, well, let's get right into it. We notice that there is no order to the terms in the dividend, which means that when we write these terms under the long division symbol, we should write them in descending powers of x. Now that looks a whole lot better. The divisor looks strange, but when we write the divisor in descending powers of x to the left of the long division symbol, it looks a whole lot better. Now we are ready to begin the four-step process. And I'm going to assume that you are very comfortable following this four-step process, which means that I'm going to go fairly quickly through these calculations, starting with 15x to the power of 5 divided by 3x, which gives us 5x to the power of 4. We take that 5x to the power of 4 and we multiply by 3x minus 2, which gives us 15x to the power of 5 minus 10x to the power of 4. When we take that 15x to the power of 5 and we subtract 15x to the power of 5, we are left with 0x to the power of 5, which is what we expect. However, when we take negative 10x to the power of 4 and we subtract negative 10x to the power of 4, we get 0x to the power of 4, which is unusual because usually we always have something at the end of our second subtraction. If it makes you feel better writing 0x to the power of 4, you can, but it's not essential. What we can do though is take the 9x cubed and bring it down. We have now cycled through these steps once, but you guessed it, we are not done yet. So let's cycle through them again. 9x cubed divided by 3x gives us 3x squared, but we must be careful and put that 3x squared in the column reserved for x squareds. We then take that 3x squared and multiply it by 3x minus 2 in order to give us 9x cubed minus 6x squared. And then 9x cubed subtract 9x cubed gives us 0x cubed, no surprises there. However, it appears that we have nothing to subtract negative 6x squared from. But we can bring down that 0x squared placeholder that we inserted earlier. And when we do that, we can take 0x squared and subtract negative 6x squared in order to give us positive 6x squared. And at this stage, we are ready to bring down the negative x and write it alongside the 6x squared. And here we go again. 6x squared divided by 3x gives us 2x. We take that 2x and we multiply by the divisor of 3x minus 2 in order to give us 6x squared minus 4x. And then 6x squared subtract 6x squared gives us 0x squared as expected. And negative x subtract negative 4x gives us positive 3x. And then we simply bring down the negative 5 and we write it alongside the 3x. If cycling through the steps three times wasn't enough, we have to do it again. 3x divided by 3x gives us 1. 1 multiplied by 3x minus 2 gives us 3x minus 2. And then 3x subtract 3x gives us 0x as expected, and negative 5 subtract negative 2 gives us negative 3. There's nothing more to bring down, so finally, we have reached the end of our calculations. After all of that, we can finally conclude that the quotient is 5x to the power of 4 plus 3x squared plus 2x plus 1. In other words, we can take this dividend and we can write it as 3x minus 2 multiplied by 5x to the power of 4 plus 3x squared plus 2x plus 1 with the remainder of negative 3. And there we have it. This spicy problem is conquered. If you enjoyed this video, then please let me know. If you feel that you can handle this level of spiciness, then try out this problem and let me know what your answer is in the comments below. If you think your friends can handle this level on the shisa meter, then please share this video with your friends. Well, that's all from me, and I want to say a very big thank you for watching.